going on, guys? It's David here. Today we are going over a technique video. We're going to be going over front squats. If you haven't checked out the back squat video we did, make sure to do that first. The link's going to be in the description, because if you can't front or if you can't back squat, I don't think you should start front squatting yet. But first thing, we're going to be looking at a couple stretches, a couple activations, and then some techniques for the lift to help you move better and do it without hurting yourself, which is the main goal for this. So first thing, let's hop into the stretches. The first mobility stretch that I'm going to show you guys is going to be a thoracic extension drill. All you're going to need is a PVC pipe or some light bar. This is a rip trainer we're using, and you're going to need a box about 18 to 24 inches tall. And all you're going to be doing is putting your elbows on the box with your arms bended about 90 degrees, and you're going to be doing cat-cows from that position. So all that is you're just sticking your back up to the ceiling and then sticking your chest to the floor as far as you can. And what you should be feeling on this is a big stretch all in your lats when you go back up to the ceiling. And then as you go chest to the floor, you should almost feel like your mid-back is about to cramp. And just keep going as far as you can up, as far as you can back, for about 5 or 10 reps, and your upper back is gonna be ready for front squats. The second stretch we're gonna be doing is one for your hips to help mobilize your groin and the back of your hip capsule for when you're getting nice and low on a front squat. So the main thing we're gonna be doing here is you're gonna grab a box that's about 18 inches high. You're gonna go hand on your foot. Make sure your toes are pushed into the ground on the box. You don't want them to be up. Hand here, you're gonna be forcing your knee out as far as you can. You should feel it right in here. And you're gonna try to drive your chest up as you go knee out here, keeping that toe on the box, keeping that chest up, back and forth. And one of the things you wanna try doing as well is trying to get your hips as low to your foot as you can. Here, drive your knee out, relax, come back again, and force your knee out as far as you can. Just go about 5 or 10 reps of that each side and you'll be good to go on those. The first activation, actually the only activation I'm gonna show you for front squats, you can warm up your glutes a little bit with bands if you want, but I really like this one because with front squats, one of the main things that's underactive is people's mid-back and scapular muscles. So this is really gonna help you warm those scapular muscles up with your hips as well. So you're gonna grab a glute ham raise machine, one of these guys. Ours doesn't have a knee pad, but this is a glute ham raise machine. Basically what we're gonna do is go into hip extension at the top with our body completely even. And we're gonna grab a set of fives. We're really, really lightweight, so you can do this with your hands if you're not strong enough to do the fives. And we're gonna go 5 to 10 reps of T's, arms straight out the side, squeezing your scapular muscles, bringing the shoulder blades in towards each other. And then we're gonna go a set of 5 or 10, but bring your arms in a Y shape overhead, keeping the glutes engaged, keeping your low back, your core engaged, and driving those hands either in the T or the Y position. So again, this is combining, using and activating your hips at the same time as your mid-back, which is what you need in a front squat. So once you do about 1 or 2 sets of this, your mid-back and glutes should be on fire, and then we're gonna be good and ready for the front squat. So try this out, let me know how it goes. Real quick, before we actually work on the front squat and show you some techniques, I wanna talk about why you would actually do it versus the back squat. So again, if you haven't seen our back squat video, look at that first. Front squat, my main reason I do it over the back squat is gonna be because you can get very similar quad hypertrophy and quad strength with using less weight. So for example, if you can do maybe a set of 315 on back squats per set of five, maybe you only need 225 or 275 for front squats to get a very similar effect in muscle activation in your quads. But the downside of that is the front squats are gonna require a lot more ankle mobility, and you're gonna have to have a lot stronger core and mid-back to be able to stabilize your spine in an upright position during the movement. So you can kind of pick and choose which one you wanna do, whether it's front or back. But again, if you haven't done the back squat, I would try that one first. For front squats, I like to do a top-down setup, which essentially means you're doing your hands first, and then when you walk out, you're gonna get your feet set up. So starting with your hands, I go just right outside shoulder width, which for me is right on the knurling of the bar. And I have pretty good wrist mobility, so I can grab the bar with 3 fingers. But if you guys don't have good wrist mobility, I would start with 2. And essentially what we're gonna do is you're going to grab the bar right apart from shoulder width. We're gonna go here. You're gonna position the bar right in this little shelf of your delt and your clavicle. It's gonna be sitting right there. It's gonna be really uncomfortable if you're not used to it, so if it hurts, that's completely normal. Just suck it up for a bit, you'll get used to it. We're gonna go here, grabbing the bar with our fingers. We get our fingers set. Once our fingers are set, we make sure it's in that slot in our shoulders, and we're really just gonna stand up with it, make sure we're in a good position. You kinda need to tuck your head back so that you don't choke yourself on the bar. So we're gonna be kind of in this position as we walk the bar back and get set up. Second thing we're gonna be talking about is how to actually properly brace your core before you do the movement. So I'm a little out of breath, I just did a set, but it's gonna be different from the back squat where you're not pulling the bar down here and tightening. You actually have to go elbows up instead of pulling the bar down. You drive your elbows up and out. You should feel tension in here in your serratus. If you don't know how to activate your serratus, go look at our shoulder videos. But we're gonna go elbows up and out. We're gonna hold here, and then once we take a deep breath here, elbows up, then we tighten our core. And it's essentially gonna be knees and hips come back at the exact same time, where a back squat would be more hips back first, a little bit. Front squat, you're gonna go elbows up, core tight, and you're gonna go knees and hips back and forward at the same exact time. So literally dropping your hips straight down, coming straight back up. So one of the main things that I see with a front squat is people's elbows come down as they start to come up. Essentially what that is that's just poor motor pattern. All I would really do to practice making that better is just gonna be lighter weight, keeping the elbows up, and maybe a little bit of mobility on your triceps and lats. So if you have the elbows come down, I would try to do a couple more sets of the thoracic extension drill that we did to help keep those elbows up. But that's the main fault that I see. The other one is people who try to shoot their hips too far back and turn it into a back squat. So you want your knees to go pretty far forward over your toes on the front squat, so you can literally drop straight down, straight back up. If you're doing it like a back squat, your elbows are gonna come forward naturally, and you're gonna lose a lot of core tightness as well. So to be able to keep that bar stable over your midfoot, you really need to have elbows up tall, hips and core right underneath your shoulders, and not back at all during the movement. Thank you guys for watching today's video. Hopefully some of the things that you were able to take away was some mobility if you feel like you can't keep your elbows up when you're doing your front squats. Some mobility for your groin if you feel like you have a hard time being able to get low enough with front squats, and some activation to help you be able to extend your chest up and keep your chest up and core tight while you're doing the front squats. Again, if you guys have any other questions, make sure to leave it in the comments, contact me on Instagram, David T. Fisher. Check out the back squat video, the shoulder video. If you don't know how to activate your serratus and get your elbows up, all those things, make sure to check them out. Thank you again for watching. I'll see you guys in the next video.